A big Mal beat his representative opponent, Terry Hill.
Mate, it's good to get a victory up over him. You know, he's a good player, but, you know, I'm here to sort of make sure I maintain the number one centre position in the competition. I think I'm doing it at this stage.
Even the sending off of Jason Croker failed to halt the Raiders. 37 minutes with just 12 men.
See worse than that. He's trying to protect himself. Toomey's head did go back. That is not a send-off offence.
Well, I'm sure this case is going to put the judiciary under some pressure, no doubt about that. He was very sure because he sent him straight off.
With Canberra hanging on to a four-point lead and a man short, hooker Steve Walters was the one to turn the tide.
Yeah, I felt a little bit determined because I didn't want to hear any crap about how much we mix Ricky and Laurie all week. You know, it's a real, you get ticket here and that every weekend.
But it was the replacements who covered themselves in the real glory. One who's sure to be seen again, Jason Burnham, David Wesley and the super sub himself, Steve Stone.
Limited opportunity when we are playing the lower grade, so when we do get one, we have to grab it with both hands.
At the end of the long weekend, the league ladder looks this way, with North still unbeaten, Canterbury moved to outright second after beating West this afternoon, with the Raiders and St George equal third. Penrith makes up the top five.
And with just a week until the first representative teams for the season are chosen, two of the Raiders' up-and-coming stars played games yesterday that said, pick me. In his weekly comment on league, Bradley Clyde looks at the selection chances of winger Ken Nagus and fullback Brett Mullins.
By Brett Mullins, who's had an absolutely superb game.
Picked a pretty good day to have a game like that, hasn't he?
Yeah, most definitely. Bob Fulton was the opposing coach, and it is a kangaroo year, so, you know, Brett's certainly putting a right foot forward.
Now, the first three times he touched the ball, I mean, we had a terrific chase on the ball, and he got through, he slid through between defenders and good defenders.
Fulton must have been impressed with Nagus as well.
Yeah, I know Kenny was looking for a big year this year, and well, have a look at this one. Kenny's got an unbelievable turn of speed, and we really do wonder sometimes how fast this guy really is. He reminds me of another winger I used to play with.
Playing great speed, but Nagus goes into another gear.
He's Chicka's namesake, and I don't think Chicka ever knew how fast Chicka was either, so I suppose young Kenny's the same. Kenny only runs as fast as he seems to have to.
The big story of yesterday's game, Brad, had to be the performance of the subs.
Yeah, our subs dug pretty deep yesterday. They really played above themselves, and now, those guys, I think, have put plenty of pressure on the established stars of our side.
Complex on site at the Queanbeyan Raiders.
And Polamalu with a serious leg injury. The injury is overshadowing the Bulldogs' fighting 6-point victory.
A blow to Canterbury in the opening 10 minutes.
This match, you wouldn't need me to tell you tonight, it was one of the Raiders' most courageous victories. Fittingly, the entire team was given the Game Day Man of the Match award. In a side of many standouts, those who pressed for selection, top of the list was long-striding fullback Brett Mullins.
That is fielded back on his own 20-metre line by Brett Mullins, who's had an absolutely superb day. Look at him go! Mullins! A 50-metre run that hasn't ended! Burnham is with it! Well, Brett Mullins! That is incredible stuff!
Our biggest problem was, you know, coming to grips with Mullins bringing the ball back. I mean, that was one of our problems, that, you know, the first three times he touched the ball, I mean, we had a terrific chase on the ball, and he got through, he slid through between defenders and good defenders.
If Brett Mullins was hoping to impress any coach in the Winfield Cup next to his own, it would have to be Bob Fulton, the current Australian coach. One of the few positions still open in the Aussie team is fullback, and Mullins certainly staked his claim yesterday.
I think he's got to obviously look at country origin side to start with. I mean, he'd be the logical choice there, but I mean, you know, Mal, I've had a chat with Mal about his performance too over the, you know, just in general conversation, and, you know, Mal's wrapped him, and, you know, he said he's come along in leaps and bounds.
Mal Meninga also made a point of destroying the representative hopes of another young buck. This time he made Terry Hill look like a reserve grader.
Mate, it's good to get a victory up over him. You know, he's a good player, but, you know, I'm here to sort of make sure I maintain the number one centre position in the competition. I think I'm doing it at this stage.
Oh, it was a challenge for Hill and Danny Moore. I think they've learnt.
Coach Tim Sheens, usually reserved in his praise of his side, wasn't so shy after yesterday's fighting win.
Would have to be close to being the best game I've seen played here.
The Raiders also got rid of the Ricky Stewart bogey, proving they could win without their superstar half. Super sub Steve Stone handed in the game of his career at the Raiders.
I'm not really worried about what the press, as long as I can play well and the team's successful and coach is happy and I'm there next week, that's enough to keep me happy.
Well, a well-deserved rest day for the Canberra Raiders today, and especially for Steve Walters. Instead of crossing to him tonight, we spoke to him after yesterday's great match. Firstly, was he at last happy with his own form?
Yeah, a bit happier, mate. It was a good win for the side. A better effort for me personally, too. I can't remember throwing any bad passes, which is the main thing, and no mistakes, and it was a real win. Good win for us. I thought Big Mal sort of led us from the front. They played a good captain's knock, and I was happy with myself and Brad too. I suppose the other sort of more experienced guy out there played well. It was a good all-round team effort. I know you hear that bull a lot of time after you win, but it wasn't the case today. I thought that the young guys that came in the side all did exactly what you'd want them to do, and as a result, we had a good win. I didn't want to hear any crap about how much we mixed Ricky and Laurie all week. You know, it's a real, you get sick of hearing that every week. And I had full confidence in Steve Stone here and Tutsu, who were filling in for those two, and I certainly hope that they get a few raps this time, because they got plenty of criticism when they don't. We don't win.
Well, for the try of the round.
Yes! Oh, let him, look at him go! Hancock is displaying great speed, but Magus goes into another gear. Magus scores, and that puts the nail in the coffin.
To the table, and North Sydney still
and bombed opportunities kept coming their way. Canterbury lost.
But Stewart is doubtful about backing up for the Raiders on Sunday. There's controversy in Newcastle before tonight's kickoff. A suggestion that this game could be the last between City and Country has provoked an angry reaction.
While the players tried to keep their minds on the job prior to tonight's game, they will take the field wondering if it's the last they'll see of the Country jumper. New South Wales league boss John Quayle has suggested that the game is obsolete. He has a fight on his hands.
I know he's the general manager of the New South Wales league, but there's a board that runs the New South Wales league, and I didn't know John made all the policy decisions. I'm very disappointed to hear him say that on the eve of the game.
Doubts over the future of the annual City-Country match have emerged every year for the past decade. But Quayle believes the introduction next year of three new clubs from outside the traditional boundaries diminish the value of playing a rep game within New South Wales.
When John gets the other states to have 55,000 registered players without schoolboys, I'll agree with him. Until he gets that in Sydney, in any other state, he's got to fight with Canterbury Rugby League.
Players questioned today had mixed views on the issue, preferring to concentrate on the immediate task.
I was with all the players yesterday and they said, don't let anything happen to this game.
In AFL news.
Good morning. Werner is still suffering from ankle ligament trouble and is in extreme doubt for the trip to the Gold Coast.
Werner was back at the physio this afternoon, a last-ditched attempt before tomorrow's fitness test in front of training staff.
The swelling is slowly going down, but it's got to come down a little bit more and a little bit more responsive.
It's been a disrupted preparation for the Raiders this week, with six players taking part in tonight's City-Country encounter. It's been hard to train as a side. For those who won't take part this evening, the pressure will be on when the club meets up with the Gold Coast on Sunday.
You know, those guys will be feeling a bit tired from Friday's game, and I think it's up to us, our job, to show the enthusiastic sort of side and be enthusiastic and, sort of lift them through the game.
In further news this afternoon, Raiders half Ricky Stewart was ruled out of tonight's City-Country clash. Stewart is still suffering from hamstring trouble and will be replaced in the number 7 by Illawarra's John Simon. It's not all bad news for Stewart, who is still available to take part in Sunday's club trip to the Gold Coast.
And with Ricky Stewart away on country origin duties, despite pulling out of tonight's clash, he can't be with us. He has passed on the good oil for round 9, though. He likes Norths, Brisbane.
Forced to cancel their final training sessions. One man who should revel in the conditions is City prop Craig Salvatore, who's looking to relaunch his representative career.
For East this year, Salvatore has been a saviour. But Big Sal knows it counts for naught. If he wants a State of Origin jumper, he has to perform tonight.
Probably the biggest game I'm going to play probably in the last couple of years. Last year I thought the City Origin game was a big game, and I was pleased with my effort there, and I've probably got to play at least a similar role, if not better.
While most would be apprehensive about taking on Country's test props, Paul Harrigan and Glenn Lazarus, to Sal, it's no big drama.
we've got to line up against those blokes to get these spots. You know, it's we line up against them every week in the competition proper. So, you know, all it is now is they're all together in one side, and it probably just makes it a little bit harder. But, you know, so are we. We've got a pretty good pack, and I'm pretty sure we can outmuscle them.
Away from the forwards, Country will be relying on the Canberra connection of Stewart and Daly. Despite it being their first game for almost a month, Coach Phil Gould remains cautious.
I mean, they're all fit athletes. Certainly their first game back may be a little shaky, but you know, they need the football. They need the football at this level, and leading into the State of Origin series, the more games they play, the better.
Meanwhile, it's a tough 2 days for Jason Taylor, David Fairley and Greg Florimo, backing up tomorrow against Cronulla.
The game against Cronulla will be a hard one. They lost last week, so they'll be keen for a victory. You know, I'll just think about Friday night's game, and then once that's over, be, you know, mind on the job for Cronulla.
On Mother's Day Sunday, Saints have moved
in. With his hamstring injury, John Simon's there.
Hamstring injury, ruling out half Ricky Stewart. Illawarra's John Simon comes off the bench and will start the match. Tonight's game kicks off one of the busiest weekends this season, with City teammates becoming opponents when they back up for club games.
Six players from Canberra, Newcastle's quartet, and a trio from Illawarra proves country cousins stick together. But most of the City Slickers are friendly foes. After tonight's representative showdown, centres Terry Hill and Chris Johns end their truce and become enemies when Manly do battle with Brisbane.
It's not the best man win because Manly is going to win. So, I'm going to say, you know, we're at Brookie Oval, you know, and we'll be expecting the win, so it's going to be good.
Oh, they're such a good side. We're probably going to do it hard, but...
Well, definitely.
And City's mate against mate syndrome doesn't end there. Tomorrow, Three Bears will suddenly turn on Cronulla's ET when North tackle the Sharks.
I'm sure Jason Taylor and David Fairley, who are in around the rucks, are going to do a lot more work probably than me out on the wing, so I'm sure they'll be in for a tough encounter on Saturday as well.
I'll probably just try and keep throwing the ball to him, so he has to do plenty of work.
Despite the history of this famous fixture, rumours persist that tonight's clash may well be the last. Most critics believe the Blues' origin side is all but chosen, and it seems foolish to toughen the workload of the state's elite players.
City versus Country, and the matchups are magnificent.
Oh, what pass! Salvatore makes a great run.
At fullback for City, Balmain's brilliant Tim Brasher.
Brasher! That's magical stuff!
Against in Canberra's scoring machine, Brett Mullins. On the flanks, blockbuster Graham Mackay.
Here's Mackay. Too big, too fast.
And for Country, nimble Ken Nagus.
Nagus. Oh, look at him go. Hancock is displaying great speed, but Nagus goes into another gear.
David Fairley spearheads the City Six as they take on Chief Harrigan and an awesome Country pack. Plus, there's red-hot talent waiting in the wings.
Florimo keeps going. Florimo! Oh! That's enormous stuff by Greg Florimo. Sergeant, they won't stop him!
City versus Country, tonight on Wide World of Sports.
The 1994 Rugby League representative season may well be likened to a ladder, with the final step, the ultimate in any player's career, a kangaroo tour to England and France. Tonight, 33 players jump on the first rung of that ladder by participating in our annual City Origin versus Country Origins clash here at Marathon Stadium in Newcastle. Virtually tonight, a possibles probables game for a State of Origin jersey. And Ray Warren, no luck for the Country boys this afternoon with a major withdrawal.
No, Sturlo, they've been dealt the cruelest blow of all, with Ricky Stewart, their star player, the halfback, succumbing to that hamstring injury that's been giving him a problem. And Stewart goes out of the side, and John Simon comes into halfback in 18. Daly pushes into 5-8. Matthew Ryan off the bench into the centres with Paul McGregor. The wingers are Wishart and Nagus, and Mullins is the fullback. The City Origin side intact. Brasher, Mackay, Johns, Hill, Eddinghausen, Fittler and Taylor. But have a look at the two packs. City Origin, Mackay, then the Giants, Serenin and Fairley, Salvatore, Elias and Roberts. Country Origin, Brad Clyde at the back, Dean Pay, David Barnhill, workers in the second row, Harrigan, Lazarus the front row, with Robbie McCormick between them. And then on the benches, A lot of expectation surrounding Craig Field for City Origin. Greg Florimo, Jim Dimmick, Mark Carroll. It just oozes class, doesn't it? Because of their problems, Country Origin will declare their fourth reserve as the match commences. They're trying to keep one fresh out of the earlier game involving Country first. Stirlo, as a result, City first's raging hot favourites now with no Stewart in the side.
Well, another withdrawal tonight is our own poor Fatty Vaughton. He's currently recuperating in hospital. We do wish him a speedy recovery. But joining us is the experienced Norse forward Mario Fenwick. He now joins Steve Roach as they discuss their thoughts on tonight's clash.
Thanks very much, Stirlo. And Mario, three certainties in the New South Wales pack in my way of thinking. Lock forward Brad Clyde and the front rowers, Lazarus and Harrigan. That leaves the hooker position and two second row positions open.
Well, I don't know if I believe in certainties, but if there should be a certainty, I believe David Fairley should definitely be a starter. He's been the form player of the Winfield Cup, and his form week in, week out has been sensational. I think Fairley, if he plays well today, should get a start in the State of Origin.
Always a boulder in the City versus Country match. Tonight, I think it might be Dean Pay. Been in exceptional form for the Canterbury Bankstown side, and he's been made captain of that side now. He must have something.
Well, Dean Pay's a great player for Canterbury. He's suffered with a lot of injuries at Canterbury, and it's a credit to him that he's bounced back, and certainly he's displayed a lot of great form. And look, if he plays well today, certainly he'll come into calculations.
I was looking forward to the clash of the halfbacks, but unfortunately, Ricky Stewart out tonight. Does that enhance Jason Taylor's chances even further?
Well, I know Jason was really looking forward to the clash between the two of them. Obviously, Ricky Stewart is the king of halfbacks at the moment, but Taylor's on the way up. But the guy they threw in, John Simon, he'll hold his own. He's got a good kicking game and certainly a very strong defensive player. I think he'll fill in very well.
Well, thanks very much, Murray. It should be a great game. As the players are just about to take the field, it's back to Ray Warren.
Thank you, Blocker. And a big crowd has certainly assembled now at Marathon Stadium for the annual clash of City and Country Origin. It's eighth year, in fact. They've played seven times, and a great honour it is to wear the maroon and gold of Country. Led out by Laurie Daly for the third time, and of course he tasted success leading this side out in 1992. He's got some fairly heavy equipment behind him. We've been through that. Bradley Clyde for one, and Dave Barnhill plays in the second row for the MMI Country Origin side. Paul McGregor, they've got their problems, as we pointed out in the preview, losing Ricky Stewart as late as 2 o'clock this afternoon, and they had to find a fourth member for the bench out of the Country firsts, who incidentally won their match against the Metropolitan Cup. And here's the City Origin side, taken out by Ben Elias. Class from tip to toe, the fireworks over Marathon. Ben Elias, he's been under enormous pressure. Terry Hill wears the number four jumper. Salvatore, one of the big guns in the City pack. Jason Taylor limbering up, and I wonder what flashed through his mind when he heard the news that Ricky Stewart would not be there for Country tonight.
Well, I've got no doubt, Ray, disappointment. He'd have been looking forward to that battle to stamp his authority on the game. John Simon, of course, his opponent tonight, has played State of Origin football very recently, so they haven't called on a bad replacement coming in the 18 jersey.
Bill Harrigan's the man in charge of the first rep game, as Peter described it, 1994. It's like the rugby league ladder. This is where they start. At the end of the day, they might be on that plane heading for England and France with the 1994 Kangaroos. Paul Sheridan wears 12. Packs into the second row with David Fairley, probably the form second rower of the Winfield Cup thus far. John Simon, an excellent kicker of the ball, will get us started. Crowd of probably in the area of 20,000 at Marathon Stadium, with Country running left to right. And I guess if there are 20,000 here, the Country side has got 75% of supporters. The blue of Sydney, the maroon of the Country. Elias. Sheridan takes it ahead. One of the veterans of City Country Origin games. This is the eighth, and Paul has played in six of them, along with Andrew Eddinghausen. A Country player has been felled. An inquisitive look over the top by David Fairley, and the kick finds touch on the far side of the ground.
Yes, and it was Big Chief Harrigan coming over the top, trying to pull off the big hit on David Fairley. To no avail, the Big Chief's up at the moment, just battling to get to the scrum.
This is what happened.
Yeah, clash of heads there. A little bit of blood around the mouth. Wonder if it'll be enough for the referee to send Harrigan to the blood bin. Scrum being set 42 metres out from the country line. Trying to get rid of that blood and play on.
And that's the problem a lot of in these games is players going for the big hit early in the match, especially when there's two or three in the tackle.
First touch of the ball for Ken Nagus. Enormous night for him. Bradley Clyde, another to the Canberra connection. And talking of that connection, there's the star that's out of the match, Ricky Stewart, alongside coach Chris Anderson. We're on the 40-metre line now. Country taking it ahead. Harrigan, not to be denied. Swamped to the ground by the City defence. Roberts was waiting for him. Through Simon, it's out with Daly. Charged down. Barnhill's with it now. McGregor puts on a step. Wishart tried to use the right foot to step inside, but this ground a little bit greasy.
Well, it's very poor play there by Wishart and the countryside. The referee had signalled six again. McGregor trying to position his winger, but was never going to have enough speed to get outside Mackay. And they really handed over possession very cheaply there when they should have had pressure on.
30-metre line behind them. Brad Mackay had a bit of a problem with a dislocated finger. Here he is carrying the football up now, 35 metres out from his own line. Ben Elias leading the City side, David Fairley. 40-metre line, blockers with us in the box tonight. And down on the sidelines, Mario Fenwick. And I guess watching it in hospital, the fat fella. And as Sturlo said earlier, we're without him tonight. And we know that he'll be watching the telecast. Good luck to you, mate. We look forward to your return on Sunday. A chance for City. Cleaned up by Country back on the 30-metre line.
And that's always been one of the Country Origins' mistakes of letting the City side get on the outside of him. We saw them use the kick just then. A good grubber kick through by Fittler. And a great chase from Andrew Ettinghausen, who nearly got the ball back.
Yeah, I actually thought ET might have been a touch offside. That's a good ploy early in any game, turning the opposition around. It means that they can't rush up as quickly in defence. It just puts the opposition in two minds defensively.
No score then, early minutes of City versus Country. Bazza has got a ball away and Country take it to within about 6 metres of the halfway. McCormick is the dummy half. A bad pass and then Daly knocks on. And this will be play on. Advantage to City. Salvatore gives it and Taylor is wrapped up. Country player down injured, Laurie Daly limping back into position. And now the weight of the Country defence force the City side back to halfway. Roberts was on the end of it. David Fairley, he got around Matthew Ryan.
Ready, Mark, boys, hands off.
And on the far side of the ground, the hillside of Marathon. And they're 30 metres out as Taylor looks for a second man play. Serenin was on the end of a great tackle by Lazarus. McCormick went in low. They come wide. Taylor on for Fittler. And across now. Put down is Terry Hill. Good tackle by Laurie Daly. No gain in ground as Taylor decides to go to the air. It's a towering kick. But they get underneath it, the Country boys. Brett Mullins. 8 metres away from his own line.
Mullins tested very early on, but he came up with a great catch. Laurie Daly came up with a super tackle on Terry Hill as well. This is the kick, everybody on side. Daly with his right knee heavily strapped. He's had ankle problems as well. Mullins did well here and was able to evade the first defender.
Talking of Mullins, he recovers the ball knocked down by City. And Mullins is brought down 21 metres out from his own line as McCormick works it away for Barnhill to take it up. Mackay makes the tackle. He gets an assist from Jason Taylor as McCormick goes across the ground. Picks up the runner of Harrigan. And Harrigan losing his footing. an easy prey for the City defence of Elias and Fairley. Now McCormick, as the markers divided pretty quickly. McCormick makes about 7 metres, plays the ball near the 40-metre line. Simon away for Daly. Daly off the right foot, keeps it fairly low as he looks for the touchline in front of the grandstand. And a little bit of nerves there from Tim Brasher. He's tackled just inside the 20-metre line. Mackay. Mackay and Ettinghausen on the wings for the City side. Graham Mackay has been in exceptional form. Played by Salvatore. Elias gives it away. Roberts it is that runs it. And they're 35 metres out from their own line. No score.
And interesting to see the City side running a bit one out at the moment. You've got to run with support, especially in these big games. The likes of Fairley and Salvatore running one out too much.
Taylor wrapped up. No gain in ground. Country tackling well. Elias works it out off his 30-metre line via the boot. The bounce favourable for Rod Wishart. And the Illawarra star goes outside his own 40-metre line to be tackled just short of halfway.
Mario, good crowd here at Marathon Stadium. What's it like down there, the atmosphere?
Oh, mate, the atmosphere is sensational on the sideline. I'll tell you what, mate, the tackling is very intense, and certainly there's State of Origin jumpers on the end of this game, and the players are showing that they're going full on the sideline here.
Blindside play now for Glenn Lazarus. He's had a busy start to the game. He's tackled 38 metres out by Paul Serenin and Terry Hill. Was there a knock-on by McCormick? The referee said no. They go along the line. Daly handles twice. Delivers a high ball for Matthew Ryan. He gets it on for Brett Mullins, who lofts the ball inside, but it's been taken there by Fairley. Fairley turns defence into attack, and he's brought down 38 out from his own line. Taylor, touch of the juggles.
Well, to catch that one, Jason Taylor. So too did Matthew Ryan in that break. We've got the fullback for Brett Mullins also nursing what looks like a rib injury at fullback. He made the bust on the left-hand side. The pass back inside was intercepted. Now Fittler taking the ball first off the ruck, looking to get involved.
And also the intercept by David Fairley. I thought he could have pinned his ears back a bit better then. He looked for the support on the inside.
On the inside, Jason Taylor finds two of his big men working at close quarters. Paul Serenin plays it on the last.
Tackle John Simon as Fittler kicks in behind Mullins. Wishart a little bit slow to react. Mullins will get there in time, 5 metres out from his own line. And another good chase led by Elias.
Just looking at the face of Brett Mullins, looking to see if he feels the effects of the ribs again. He does as Wishart scampers out from dummy half.
And this is when City are at their best. Watch Benny Elias chasing from marker. I know that he might be getting on in years a bit, but he's been responsible for a couple of muck-ups by the countryside by his chase from marker.
20 metres out from their own line. A bit of pressure here for country. They can't afford to make the mistake. Elias calling the shots from up around the middle of the ruck, of course, as captain. Organising the defensive line as the country boys go for the kick. And on the fifth, it's booted down the ground. Again, Tim Brasher makes a minor mistake. He's back on his 20-metre line. And Brasher, who had that superb game for Balmain last Friday night, plays it on his own 30-metre line. Ettinghausen comes away to the open side of the ground. Is picked off at a good tackle, though. That's Paul Harrigan wearing number 10. A busy start for him. Taylor goes down. Lazarus came over the top. Half-pie apologised. He might have got a knee in the back there, Taylor. This is Fairley.
We've seen a couple of players slipping and sliding fairly on that occasion. A week of rain up here at Newcastle, so Marathon Stadium in tremendous condition considering that. Good defence there from Matthew Ryan. Read the set play, came up with the good tackle.
10 metres short of the halfway. They go back to go forward, and Taylor it is who puts the ball through the hands. Looks for an alternate kicker. There are plenty of them in the team. That was Brad Fittler. And now it's up to country to bring it back, and again through Brett Mullins, 10 metres short of the halfway. No score on the board so far as Canterbury's Dean Pay lumbers up to them, and he couldn't have picked two bigger men probably. The second rowers Fairley and Serenin met him. Lazarus is taken to ground now by Salvatore and Serenin. Or Roberts it was. The ball comes free and the penalty goes to country.
Yes, guilty of that a fair few times this season, Ian Roberts. He makes the tackle over the top. We see the arm in there. pulling on the ball at Lazarus. Yeah, fair penalty from referee Bill Harrigan right on the spot.
So as the villain goes away from the scene of the crime, John Simon takes the first penalty of the game. 30 metres out, the tap from McCormick. And Lazarus said, let's try and get it right this time. He reaches the 20-metre line. McCormick away. Simon on. Daly through. And out there wide is Brad Clyde. He probably didn't have to be a Rhodes Scholar to think that he'd be out there looking for it. He'll handle again on this set of six and wouldn't mind betting. Daly figuring prominently in the first three plays, setting up their final move. And this is Dean Pay galloping through the centre. The ball goes loose. It came off the feet, I thought, of a City player. Referee Harrigan said he didn't play at the ball. He lets the tackle count continue. Simon across for Daly. Daly's floating pass. Didn't come off the hands of McGregor. It's with Ryan. Well taken by Wishart. Wishart is thumped away to the ground. 15 out from the line. There they are. That's the proximity to the uprights. As John Simon chances the bomb. He puts them onside. It comes down to the City side. And a penalty goes to them. A penalty goes to City.
And we'll see here that John Simon impedes Tim Brasher before the ball comes down. No doubt about that. Referee looking to play some sort of advantage. There was none to City. So awards the penalty. They find touch 20 metres out from their own line.
And Petey has been under pressure early in this match. Brasher already made a couple of early errors and good positioning there from John Simons to put up the big bomb.
Yeah, it's good option. Ordinary start really from Brasher. He's the more experienced of the two fullbacks out there, of course, with Brett Mullins. And on two occasions, his first two touches of the football, they weren't clean takes.
Fairly now. Working after Roberts had taken the initial play. Terry Hill linking up with Ettinghausen, who plays the ball and Taylor knocks on. There's a chance for Country, 33 metres out. No score in Country Origin versus City after 13 minutes. A nil all the scoreboard. Friday night league from Marathon Stadium in Newcastle. And the Country boys get a good chance here. Winning the scrum, the first tackle is made. About 7 metres into opposition territory. Daly working overtime. These matches have a special significance for people like Laurie Daly. They cut their teeth in rugby league in the deep country. Barnhill likewise. Let's go down to the sidelines as Country goes on to the attack. It's McGregor away for Matthew Ryan. Pulled down 22 metres out from the line. A couple of tackles left on this set. Simon got a bad pass. Harrigan goes ahead. Mackay wraps him up over the top. Five tackles gone. Back with Simon. Now Daly. Daly puts it on the boot, looking for Wishart. Mackay is underneath it. Wishart's underneath it as well. And Brad Clyde dives on it. It's the turnover. Bit of drama for the City side in this particular passage of the game, Mario.
Yes, sir. John Simon, what a great replacement for Ricky Stewart. He's got a great kicking game. He's as strong as a bull, and he's certainly doing a good job out there. I can hear him talking to his players. He's organising them very well.
And, Murray, I've been very impressed with Chris Johns on the left-hand side of the field for the City side. A couple of times he's had the big Chief Harrigan and Lazarus motoring full steam ahead. He's a great front-on defender.
He's a great defensive player, Johns, and certainly he's a player who's proven, and this is his cup of tea tonight.
While that was going on, you may have seen a tremendous tackle by Glenn Lazarus on Ian Roberts. And now Ciro is put down. Centre of the ground, a couple of metres outside the 30-metre line. Back for Taylor. Simon puts the pressure on him. Taylor gets a torpedo punt way down the ground. And Brett Mullins is back on his 10-metre line. That was a kick from Taylor of some 70 metres. Country come away via Magus. Matthew Ryan called into the run-on side with the late withdrawal of Ricky Stewart.
What a meteoric rise it's been for Matthew Ryan. 6 weeks ago, he was preparing to play in the Coffs Harbour competition, and he's losing nothing out there against his more illustrious centre company. He's had a good start to this game, the first 15. Got very involved, as has Daly. That kick, not particularly good. Brasher didn't have too much to do. McGregor's chased very easily.
Wishart wraps Brasher up very quickly. Taylor, a short pass away for Graham Mackay, who looks for the gap. David Barnhill comes from down in the Leeton Gender area.
And what a breath of fresh air it is when you are a forward and a bloke like Graham Mackay on the wing, you can take the ball up just like a forward, gives you that little bit of a break and gets you right in the middle of the park.
Right on the halfway line on the hillside of the ground at Newcastle's Marathon. This is the sixth time City Country Games have been played in Newcastle. This is the second Origin match at Marathon. As Brad Fittler drops it onto the boot, looking for the line and allowed to go by Rod Wishart.
Yeah, I'm a bit surprised there that Ben Elias decided to throw the ball to Fittler, kicking on the wrong side of the field for him, a left-footed kick. You see the head-to-head play between the two sides, dominated by City. Country would love nothing better to exact some sort kind of revenge tonight. I'm sure that we'll see Elias with that facility of being able to kick out of dummy half. Everybody on side start to take on a little bit of that role as the match progresses.
Wishart wrapped up on the first tackle. Penalty goes to Country. Inside the 10 against the City side. This is what Bill Harrigan saw, bringing about the sounding of the whistle and the issue of the penalty to Country. So they've got the better of the penalties. Simon finding the line. That last win of Country was in 1992 under the leadership of Laurie Daly. And of course prior to that was back in 1975 in that team that included Michael Cronin. And that was probably Country's greatest hour. A team of very big names were in the City side that day. Now the Country make the ball do the work. They find a second rower out very wide in Barnhill. He's put away on the 40-metre line. Dean Pay, one of the form players of the Winfield Cup. Didn't come as any great surprise to see his name come out in the opening rep game of the year. Daly with a short ball for McGregor, able to get it away for Simon, who beats Sirenin, but Roberts is there to close the gap with Mackay, and that's where they are, just inside the 30-metre line. McCormick away for Daly. Daly scheming and probing as Salvatore comes up with a fortuitous bounce.
He's had a lot of involvement, Laurie Daly, but his execution, I don't think, has been that good. We're not seeing vintage Daly at the moment. A couple of kicks there, you saw his reaction. He knew that was a pretty ordinary attempt. The sweeper there in Salvatore did a great job, but even some of Daly's passing, which is normally so crisp, really has been a little bit ordinary.
Again, you would have seen Lazarus involved in a very heavy tackle, and again, his victim was Ian Roberts. Lazarus seems to be sweating on Roberts everywhere he goes and decides to bring the ball up. Lazarus is waiting with a bone-crushing tackle.
And Roberts got tremendous skills there, although he's this type of player who can absorb a big hit. As we saw just a minute ago, Lazarus hit him with that big front-on tackle, but he's still able to get the football away.
The breakdown in communication, again, we've seen a little bit of that from dummy half. Mackay going back inside, went without the football. So Country have probably enjoyed the better field position. Again, have a chance to keep pressure on. Nagus nearly goes straight through.
52-0 in favour of City over Country in the under-17s. Country on the attack now. As Brad Clyde looks to turn it inside, they approach the 20-metre line, centre of the ground. Good place for them to attack. They've got a very wide blind side on the right. And here's a penalty being given to Country. An infringement from City in this tackle. And apparently he's eventually pinched him for actually raking the ball out. It was Ian Roberts. And the first reasonable scoring attempt coming up 20 metres out, just off centre, for Rod Wishart. Novocastrians on the field and off the field. They love their football here. I refer to that 1975 match when Mick Cronin played for Sydney. The team for Sydney that year was Fairfax, Anderson, Chris, Fulton, Brannigan, Schubert, Pickup, Radonicus, Coote, St. Stevens, Beetson, McMartin and McCarthy. So it was a a formidable lineup in the Sydney side, wasn't it?
It wasn't bad, the countryside. Brentnell was there, Terry Fay, Ian Martin. Jim Morgan went on to play for Australia. They did cause an upset as Wishart moves in.
21 metres out, strikes it nicely, flags up, first score, first points go to country. 21 minutes gone, they lead 2-0. Welcome back to the Marathon Stadium in Newcastle, hosting tonight City versus Country. Being beamed by the Nine Network around Australia, the first of our rep matches for the new year. Lazarus plays it, and there's another result from earlier games that started this afternoon in the early part. 54-4, Sydney over Country.
And Benny Elias being called out for a high shot here. The little man on the big man. He had to jump up pretty high to get Bradley Clyde. Then here we see it. Well, I don't really know about that one. Had to jump up to get around there, Pete.
Head high for mine, block.
Penalties are 4-1 now to Country. Bit of a problem in that area for coach Phil Gould. Harrigan to the halfway. And there's that score again. Country first, 25 against the New South Wales Metropolitan Cup rep side, 22. 25-22. Bradley Clyde tackled on the halfway, with his side leading 2-0. A penalty just a few minutes back for Rod Wishart.
Just wonder whether they're playing Brad Clyde too wide too early on in this game. The whole match stationed outside Daly. We thought that his value might have been close to the ruck, being able to make some bust there and then drift out later in the tackle count.
And that's Bradley Clyde's general go. He's probably the first back on kick reception, the first bloke back there to take the ball, and does cause a lot of damage first off the ruck. I'd have to agree with you, Pete.
Roberts to the halfway mark now. Swamped by the country defence. Lazarus hunting there with Dean Pay. Serenin gets another 7 or 8 metres of ground for the Sydney side. 2-0 in favour of Country. Taylor looking for a gap that hasn't presented itself thus far. And everything that Taylor has done, he's been matched by John Simon. Fittler puts it up. Brescia to me looks offside. And here's a penalty going to the City side. They're claiming obstruction on Tim Brescia, who I thought was offside anyway.
Well, let's have a look. He's claimed Laurie Daly has changed direction to get in the way of the chaser. He was close to being onside there. You can see that they have made a conscious effort to go across and impede Brascia. No idea where the football's coming down, and that's got to be the first concern. And I think that's a good decision, and a decision we don't see often enough in weekend rugby league.
Well, that's the reason for the penalty. Not only was it obstruction, but it was intentional. Daly went out of his way to block Tim Brascia, and looking at that replay, I agree with you, Peter, he was fractionally onside. But right in front now, a chance to equal is presented for Jason Taylor. I'd like to be getting a shade of black about this, wouldn't you? Taylor from right in front. And no problem, so 2 points all. More than halfway through the first half, the crowd enjoying it. They enjoyed the preceding game too, with players, of course, still based in the country. 2 points all then after 24 minutes.
And obviously, 24 minutes dominated by defence. I'm talking about Jason Taylor. The important thing with Taylor's game is he is still going towards the defensive line, and that's been the big improvement in his game over the last 12 months. He's going to the defence, and a ball player must do that to try and commit defenders. No breaks for him tonight, but the more he does it, the more chance it will happen.
Pete, do you think it'd be better off if he started shuffling the ball out, you know, in the first 20 minutes and then went, you know, for the gap run every couple of times?
Well, that's probably a good tactic as well, I would imagine, but really he's just got to play what's in front of him. If he thinks that there is something on, take advantage of it. If not, throw the football. He's got great strike power outside, and that too is a very good kick from Taylor. Found good distance and also didn't go to the fullback on the full.
Brett Mullins tackle just inside the 30 metre line. Simon away from dummy half, picks up about 5 metres, but again defensive line of both sides remains intact. Harrigan, there hasn't been what you could call a clean break. Lazarus working as a pivot. Daly turning it in for Clyde.
Mario, nothing on the scoreboard between these sides. In your mind, anybody getting the ascendancy up front?
Sterlo, the game's in the balance. I see the game being decided by the two halfbacks, Simon and Taylor. They're both generals out there, and I can hear them talking and marshalling their troops. There's not much in the game. I think it'll come down to who makes the most mistakes.
McGregor gave a pass for Wishart, who had to go back to take it. And Brasher works off his 20-metre line, runs it away from Daly, slithers out of McGregor. Simon makes the tackle, Taylor gives a quick service, and Terry Hill is tackled. What's Ben Elias here for a moment? A dummy half.
Well,
he's not going to get that opportunity. The ball comes out, and Harrigan's going to put a scrum down. I was going to make the comment about Ben Elias, and it might not be the case, but he seems to be giving the ball to his halfback all night long. He hasn't really been doing anything himself with it. I reckon that'd be an instruction from Phil Gould.
Yes, and we're looking at, you know, only 12 minutes to go before halftime. I think we'll see Ben Elias run the ball a bit more. I think he's been told by Phil Gould to shuffle it out. When you see one man on the ground, then you can run. The defence is so good in this game.
Well, there's a mistake from Brad Clyde. He's going to that big tackle, Harrigan, on Terry Hill. I think he'd have got a fair deal of satisfaction out of that one. Last time they met here in club football, it was a fairly auspicious afternoon, and Harrigan came up with the big shot there. A few mistakes starting to creep into this game.
And after that shot, I'm sure that Terry Hill wishes he was a bit better on his feet using the step as we ran into the big chief.
So here's Fittler delivering a long pass. Oh, Terry Hill, that was magnificent. Graham Mackay, 42 metres out from the line. Terry Hill was under immense pressure, but still able to take the tackle and deliver a pass. Played by Fairley. Elias again continuing to give it. It's a case of give, give, give by Benny Elias. He was under criticism, I remember, last Origin time for jinking the attack by taking it himself too many times. And I reckon Phil Gould has said something to him. Lazarus. Second man play. Dean Pay with it. 2 points all. Wishart came off his wing to take that play.
Yes, and you notice there Jason Taylor in the line. Wishart picked him out and run straight over the top of him. That could be one of the problems for Jason Taylor, his defence in the state of origin.
Daly kicks it down the ground long, and guess who's leading the chase? Brad Clyde. Ball goes in touch in goal. That brings it back for a 20-metre place kick. Bradley Clyde, terrible run of injuries, but he seems to be completely fit now. Salvatore picked off in defence, again by Glenn Lazarus. We'll get a tackle count on Lazarus. It mightn't be as high as I think it is, but my goodness, it's got quality in it.
There's another one, Ray. A great tackle by Glenn Lazarus. They've said that he's lost 5 kilos over the last couple of weeks to get ready for this representative season. It's certainly showing tonight.
Well, he's done 13 tackles in this first half. That's the leading count for the countryside. He's also hit the ball up 9 times. So you're getting plenty of work out of the big fella up front. It's been a great battle between the four front rowers.
Taylor's kick. Mullins gets a hand to it, so everybody's automatically onside. Mullins tries to split between Mackay and Hill. He almost succeeded too and then thought about passing. He's on the 30-metre line. Wishart making himself as useful as he possibly can. McCormick serves up for Daly, then Clyde, and then a flick pass by McGregor. Gives Clyde a bit of room to work in. They're about 5 metres short of halfway, as you can see.
What about the cover there? Ian Roberts coming up on the tackle very wide. Great work from the big man. A penalty here for Country. City inside the 10.
And what a superb athlete Ian Roberts is. A great chaser, you said, Peter. I remember last year's State of Origin when Queensland looked like getting back into the game. It was Ian Roberts to make the big chase and make the great play in that game.
So Mark Sargent has gone on now for Country. He's taking the place of his Newcastle colleague, Paul Harrigan. The chief comes off and Sarge goes on. Lazarus whacks it up towards the 20-metre point. Are we coming towards the first try of the game? Sargent had a super game against the Bears last Sunday. Our sideline eye would be able to tell us that. Simon across, Daly quick hands, Pay, or Ryan I should say, very close to the sideline, but then he submits in the tackle.
Yes, and obviously Country think there's a bit of a weakness down this right-hand side of the, or left-hand side of the City defence. They keep hammering down here.
Clyde did well, got it away from McCormick on to Sargent. Daly links up, and they're 11 metres from the line. McCormick works the blind side. Dean Pay runs onto it strongly. Bradley Clyde, a try, yes! Country gets the first.
And great work from Dean Pay. They may have underestimated him out wide. He's got good ball skills, a player that has been dogged by injury, but he's done a great job here. They got another set of six. Dean Pay went straight through the gap left there by Chris Johns, was able to swivel and get a good ball to Brad Clyde. He scouted out wide. That's been rewarded with the first four-pointer.
And it has been Dean Pay early in this match. He's been able to offload a couple of balls. A great pass from him. And that's a try to Bradley Clyde in the corner. Tremendous try for the Countryside not very long ago in this first half.
They just overread it there, didn't they? Both Eddinghausen and Johns stayed out. And then Eddinghausen came in when he probably wasn't needed. So it was a real mix-up out wide between two very experienced players. The big gap was there for Pay. He took it. John staying out on his man. But you'll see Eddinghausen comes in, and that leaves Clyde unmarked.
But what it was good sense from Dean Pay. A great charge of him, 100 miles an hour onto the ball. They went off him, a long ball to Bradley Clyde, and that's a try in the corner.
And it's also a task coming up now from over near the sideline for Rod Wishart. But Brad Clyde, with his high rate of involvement, there's a very good chance that he would be the first player to score a try. Watching Daly and Clyde as they came back, exchanging thoughts. If they're the outsiders for this match, nobody has told Brad Clyde and Laurie Daly. Wishart from the sideline, look at this one, oh it's a beauty! Converted try for Country, they lead 8-2 after 33.
But basically give that to Lazarus. Lazarus in the last 10 minutes has pulled off a couple of big hits, and his work with the ball is just sensational. Throwing Brad Clyde, who's worked very hard as well, and I think Country are getting on top.
Mario, a bit of movement down there on the City bench.
It looks like Mark Carroll's going on. Mark Carroll goes on for Craig Salvatore.
Right, so Ryan is brought down about 42 metres out on the last tackle now. Daly looks for a runner to go with him. Brasher is there to clean it up for the City side. Back on his own 10. He loses the ball. Eddinghausen has to clean it up in turn. Eddinghausen, taken down by Clyde, cleaned up by Wishart.
And again, we were talking earlier, Peter, about Laurie Daly's kicking game, another nothing kick, but he turned it into a great kick after a great chase. Force the error on Timmy Brasher.
Yeah, and he kicks only as good as its chase, and he led the way, forced the ball out. Timmy Brasher, a pretty ordinary night out there. Normally a very good handle as Fittler nearly steps his way straight through. They've got 5 minutes to hit back in this first half, the City side. They've got 80 metres to travel.
Carroll with his first touch of the ball.
And a good replacement. This game's been played at a very physical rate in the forwards. And Mark Carroll certainly enjoy his time in the field. A very exciting player, Mark Carroll. Loves his footy. Loves the tough stuff up front.
Rod Wishart now. McGregor. Simon. The Illawarra connection. Mullins. 45 metres out from the City line. And they've got the only converted try of the match on the board. Carroll goes on for Salvatore, who leaves the field, the Eastern Suburbs captain. Across to Daly. He hears the call from McGregor. Clyde is out wide. And Clyde is tackled 28 metres out from the line. Grandstand side of the ground as we go into that low camera shot from Wishart over to Simon. And then Daly again looking for Sargent. And Sargent really putting some pepper into the country attack. McCormick on the last through Simon for Daly. Barnhill is with him, but the kick goes to ground, so it'll be a knock on. And a great chance here for country again, the way I read it.
Well, similar to the last kick from Laurie Daly, it wasn't good leaving the boot, but they've come up trumps with the result. You see Mackay, Jason Taylor trying to stop the ball bouncing around, and eventually Taylor's hand was the last to touch.
Yeah, I would like to see the countryside run the football a bit more on the last tackle. They've opted to kick on at least five occasions, and Kenny Nagus on the wing, plenty of pace from him.
Nagus playing it just inside the 20-metre line. Now Simon, 12 metres out from the line, McCormick. Daly comes into the play. He's 5 metres out from the line now, Daly. To the right they come. Simon runs to the line. Dean Pay. Yes! The Bulldog gets a try. What a game Dean Pay is having.
And it comes back to the kick where they got six again from the scrum win. Good ball from John Simon. It didn't really open up much of a hole for Dean Pay, and he's done it all with strength. He's had a great start. Comes from behind John Simon. Pretty ordinary miss there from Paul Sirenin. In fact, he's beaten two tackles in the front line, and the cover defence couldn't stop him from going over under the post.
And it's all come from Dean Pay running at 100 miles an hour, as he's done all through the first half, and a great reward from him. It was Sirenin who missed the tackle on the inside, and he's just charged over the line, Dean Pay. As I said earlier, he's got a fair few offloads in this game, and he's also showed that he can run the football.
What a glorious start it's been for him, and it must be tremendously warming for that man, Chris Anderson, his club coach. 14 tackles and 9 hit-ups for Dean Pay.
And Chris Anderson saying earlier in the day in the paper, Ray, if you read it, saying let's pick this New South Wales side on form, and on form in the first half, Dean Pay has to be somewhere in the second row.
It was a well-aimed comment by Chris Anderson. I know exactly what you're alluding to. And he probably was thinking of blokes like Dean Pay having a blinder tonight. Rod Wishart raises the flags. This crowd, as I told you, partisan, country's way. And the scoreboard is very much that way. 14-2. And this was how the try came. Look at Simon. He knew Dean Pay was there. He just served it up, and Pay gets the try. So barely will they have time to restart. And Ben Elias and his charges will be back listening to the sound advice, I'm sure, of Phil Gould. Just get the impression, watching it from a fairly high vantage point, that country, Mario, you can have a comment with me here if you like, they just look more hungry, more enthusiastic to win.
They're certainly getting on top, country, led by their good forward pack, Clyde, Lazarus. They're really getting on top. But the thing that's important to note is the fact that City have made a lot more errors than country. So consequently, country have had more field position. That's the difference between the two teams.
There's the siren. The first half is over with the countryside. Two converted tries. Bradley Clyde and Dean Pay scored the tries. The extras, of course, off the boot of Rod Wishart. City yet to score a try. They leave for the break at 14-2 down. And there's no smiles there. In fact, some worried looks on some of the senior faces. Phil Gould, of course, the coach of City, will be keen to get to his charges. Chris Anderson can only but say, keep it going. 14-2. An enthusiastic start, rewarded for country. We'll take a break. Sterlo will be back with Blocker and the halftime summation in just a moment.
Stadium in Newcastle, and you can tell that they've been inspired. We've got the country music in the background. At halftime, they lead 14-2 in a first half where they were very good, especially with their handling. Only five errors from the countryside. Four for the city side, but the important thing there was that they turned over the ball in their own territory. Only five missed tackles for country up against 13. They've had a little bit of fortune with their kicking game, the countryside. Laurie Daly getting very involved, and I guess that he's forced the opposition into some mistakes. Steve, these big games won by the forwards, how have you seen the clash up front?
Well, I thought it was pretty even up until the last couple of minutes in the first half. But look, Lazarus leading the way there, 13 tackles, 12 hit up, having a magnificent first half, leading the platform for players like Dean Pay. He's been outstanding, 14 tackles, 9 hit ups. Bradley Clyde, amazingly, not many tackles from him, but he's been lurking out wide, and 11 hit ups still from him.
Now the city side, you know, we saw a great battle early on, but they did start to miss a few tackles late.
Yes, they did, but it's Ian Roberts who's leading the tackles for the city side and the hit-ups. David Fairley also been very involved in this game. Look at him, 17 tackles and 9 hit-ups. Very good work rate from them both players.
Is it fair to say with a 12-point lead at halftime, if country are the next to score, too big a hill to climb for City?
Well, I think it would. The thing that Gus Gould would be talking about now would be ball control. We've got to get a better kick away. Let's not lose the ball too early in the tackle count.
I think one of the instructions at halftime will be a field goal early on from country, just to put them 13 clear, meaning City had to score 3 times. Tomorrow, Commonwealth Bank Cup continues. Schoolboy football, we saw some great stuff here from the under-17s and under-19s, and we'll see some talent come through from this Commonwealth Bank Cup competition as well. Maris Brothers Pagewood up against Marcel and College of Randwick. From this game, we've chosen this as our Coca-Cola Junior Play of the Week.
Ray gets it away to Axiak. Now away to Trimmer. Strong charge, he could go all the way. Can he? Trimmer over the head. The pass away to Barnes. He gets the ball down. It's a try to the skipper, Troy Barnes. Neil Armand will award the four-pointer. So the skipper comes up with a try. Marcel and College made to pay for their mistake.
Once again, we do thank Coca-Cola for their involvement in Junior Rugby League. And speaking of tries, 2 tries here in the first half, both scored by country, both involving Dean Pay. The first try set up by Pay, a good pass to Brad Clyde. You pointed out he was lurking out wide, but a great bit of work inside, some ordinary defence from the city outside men.
Yes, it was. What happened was the city side didn't close up on the inside. A great run from Dean Pay. He charged onto the ball. Good vision from him. Bad defence from Chris Johns. A ball to Brad Clyde, who kept alert. Very good play from him to score the try in the corner. Good play from both players.
Yeah, and as I said, Dean Pay involved in the second try as well. John Simon, the little ball off the shoulder. Pay came from behind, and that was instrumental in setting up
the
try.
Well, that's the thing that I really enjoyed about Dean Pay's first half, his ability just to charge onto the ball. Paul Sheeran wrong-footed there. Dean Pay ended to score the try right under the post.
Okay, and a little bit biased. Country going and win this game?
I'm sure they can. They've been very strong in the first half, especially led by Lazarus and Dean Pay in the forwards.
Well, a guy sitting at home, well, sitting in hospital tonight, hasn't been able to join us, Paul Vaughton. I'm sure that he's enjoyed this first 40 minutes, and will do so the second half. But he'll be back on deck on the Footy Show Sunday morning at 12 p.m. Plenty to look forward to.
Well, g'day and welcome to the Footy Show for 1994.
What about that? Oh.
It's a who am I? I was born in Toowoomba in 1960 and now I'm nearly bald. Anyone? Tony. Yes, Peter Fairley, you're right.
Still late. You're going to ask me who the best player of Coates is?
Who is the best player of Coates?
Oh, I'd have to say Fatty or Bad Me.
We've got to stop the ball, so when you hit him, hit him hard! Cruncher!
If you whack someone and he's got to leave the field, I think you should leave the field too.
You've only got to look at the phone poll to see that.
Nothing
it's like very divided, the community.
Another question about Bonanza. What was the name of the cook?
Hong Fu.
I was walking down the road and I saw a pair of blue tits. What are we looking at?
A cop car.
A cop car?
Police car.
Plenty happening again on the Footy Show this weekend. Our guests will include John Lang, Scott Goulet will be in, so too Greg Florimo, having a great season for Norths. A big representative season coming up, led by the City Country fixture tonight, but have a look at this. State of Origin number 1, Queensland, New South Wales, 23rd of May at the Sydney Football Stadium. On the 1st of June, we go north of the border for the World Club Championship Challenge between Brisbane and Wigan. The second State of Origin takes us south of the border on June 8, down to the MCG, looking for a big crowd down there. Monday the 20th of June, Lang Park, the third and final State of Origin match. And still, down the track. The first test match of the year, Australia versus France at Parramatta Stadium, 6th of July. And of course, the Kangaroo Tour commences October 5. The first game there up against Leeds, who, as we saw last Saturday night, boast the skills of both Gary Schofield and Ellery Hanley. Plenty to look forward to, but I'm looking forward to the second 40 minutes tonight. I'm a little bit biased being a country boy. They lead at halftime in this fixture, 14 points to 2. We'll be back after the break with Ray Warren.
Great atmosphere here at the Marathon Stadium as we welcome you back now to the start of the second half. And City have got all the work to do. Talking of work, Lazarus got through a whole pile of it, didn't he? In that first half, 13 tackles and 12 hit-ups. An enormous work rate for the Bronco.
And a good work rate for a forward or a front row forward would be 20 tackles and around the 20 hit-up mark. So he's way above that early in this second half.
Barnhill now. Bradley Clyde, one of the try scorers for the country, working close to the sideline. McCormack. Both dummy halves have been giving excellent service to their playmakers. Neither have really exploded. Just as I said that, McCormack gave an awful pass and Simon knocks on. Well, Mario, what were you able to extract from the halftime talks by both coaches?
Ray, in the country dressing room, Chris Anderson was obviously very happy. He told his side that the reason they're on top is because they're controlling the ball and City are obviously making a lot more mistakes. He said to keep going forward and control the rucks. In the City dressing room, Coach Phil Gould told his players that they, not to panic, but they had to be the first side to score. He said they had to reform better on their kick returns. In other words, when they kick the ball downtown, they have to be there to control Mullins. He felt Mullins was a bit of a danger for them, but he said not to panic and make sure we're the first team to score. Also, Jim Dimmick's come on to replace Brad Mackay in the City team.
Okay, thank you, Mario. And I do strongly believe that they have to be the next side to score because another six-pointer and this match would be pretty much out of the reach of the City side as they bumble their way into another error.
And that's the sort of thing that City doesn't want early in this second half. David Fairley trying to get the impossible ball away on the fourth tackle. Here he has three defenders on him, tries to get the miracle ball away, and I don't think Gus Gould will be very happy about that.
Barnhill now. Play 40 metres away from the country line. Simon on for Sargent, still on the paddock. Harrigan still off. Beautiful pass by Sargent, gave Simon an opportunity to make some more ground. McGregor sweeps across the park from the right to the left to come in on this play, but Daly runs away from them, goes up the centre, makes a half break. 32 metres out from the line, centre of the ground. Brasher hangs on in defence. Simon rakes it in one-handed. Wishart is going fast with Taylor. Taylor cleans it up, but just in the nick of time.
Lovely kick there, well planned by the country attack. John Simon knows it. They're pretty short there. You can see only two in the City line. The fullback was up in the line, and Jason Taylor, he doesn't do a great job of getting this over sideline, but does enough.
Great play from John Simon there. He saw that Timmy Brasher was up in the defensive line and just opted to kick ahead. You'll see Rod Wishart with his arm up over there telling him to kick, and a race for the ball, and good play from Taylor to be there right on time.
The ominous sign there, Ray, was the bust made by Laurie Daly up the middle. It means that a couple of those City blokes are a little bit tired in the middle of the ruck.
And what happens there, especially when there is a break made in the middle of the ruck, it looks like the whole team goes right to where the ball is, and there's always space on the edges after that.
Played by Barnhill. Simon across. Straight up the centre goes Dean Pay, drawing three defenders in. McCormack calls for a quick play of the ball. Simon pushes it out. Daly turns it in. Ryan it is with the ball. 15 out from the line now. Matthew Ryan, McCormack, Simon, Sargent. To the 10-metre line he goes. The last, Daly or Simon, which way will it go? Simon, drop goal, and it's there. No, it's not. He's waved it down.
Another great chase from Benny Elias here. We saw him. John Simon took an eternity, it seemed like. A great chase from Elias, as we see. He has to step back inside and have the pot shot. Benny came again. Good chase from Benny Elias.
The country actually claiming that Elias touched the ball. They wanted a line dropout. He didn't get that. Surinam takes the 20-metre tap, and now Carroll takes it up second hit.
14-2, 4 minutes of the second half gone. Fairly. Not a great deal of use made of the reserves bench. Fittler's pass. Chance here for Nagus. Driven into the ground by Chris Johns. Play recalled for knock-ons.
And a good decision there by Bill Harrigan. We saw that the ball did come forward off one of the country players. We see the ball going through the hands there. Come off the number 15 for the country side. And that's a good decision from him. That'll be the City feed and loose.
And out now for Chris Johns. 35 metres out from his line. His team behind by 12. Taylor turning it inside for Jim Dimmock. Dimmock in 16. He was really under some pressure. I look down on the sidelines and I see that Greg Florimo, one of the real form players of the Winfield Cup, is starting to limber up. You start thinking about replacements.
And it could help Jason Taylor a bit too. We know that him and Florimo are North Sydney teammates. Florimo, a great straight runner. And Taylor, great at putting the ball in.
Fittler's pass inside for Brescia. Brescia, 10 metres out from the line. 5 metres out now at the completion of the tackle. Ben Elias swings it back for Fittler. He pushes it on in one motion for Ettinghausen. Then for John, slick pass for Ettinghausen. And then a slip catch. But a penalty goes to the City side.
And a slip catch by Glenn Lazarus. What was he doing back there? Tremendous play from the City side to keep the ball alive. And then the chip through. Great hands from Taylor.
So a chance here for the City team. A try that they really must score. A try that they need more than country at this point in time. Down by 12. Benny Elias. Here's the call. Taylor to go back. They're outnumbered on the right, but that's the place they went. Dimmock struggles to play up quickly. Ben Elias gives it back for Mark Carroll. And Carroll is held up in goal.
Good work there from Elias. Realised that the second marker wasn't working. In fact, they might have just had the one marker. Got outside, went to the first defender. They've done a good job here. Glenn Lazarus somehow gets the hand out there to stop the ball being placed.
And it was that man too. Again, Matt Ryan, the number 15 for the country origin side, is having a blinder.
Terry Hill out wide now, working off Brad Fittler. They're 10 metres out from the line. Country have been asked to absorb a lot of pressure as the ball is thrust away from Elias. Then Johns was there to take it, and he's bombarded over the top by Sargent. Taylor now, across for Dimmock. Dimmock's pass is a shocker, and Country come up with it. The ever-alert Brad Clyde dives on it. McCormick runs away with it now. Good yards. Right out to the 30 for McCormick.
Yes, and we noticed straight away on the turnover, McCormick running from Ballyhale straight at Jason Taylor to get in the line.
Wishart put away by over-the-top Serenin. Carroll underneath. Then Clyde. Now Barnhill. This is Daly. Face ball for Ryan. And he's brought down by Chris Johns. Nagus gives the pass. Clyde is there again. And he's 42 metres out from the line.
And Serenin hobbling. Looks like he's hanging onto his groin area. I think Paul Surinan's in a bit of trouble at the moment for the City of Origin side. Might see a replacement any minute now.
Daly kicks. Ettinghausen fields and goes back. 14-2 then. And just as it looked like City might have been going to score, a mistake was on offer. Fittler runs around. Mackay got him a pass back and then he was shut down in good defence by Paul McGregor.
I just wonder how important that period of time around the 10-minute mark into the second half is going to prove. Really, City, they had a lot of possession down there. I thought that they'd have been able to run in points. In the end, they just handed the ball over so meekly. That was a very bad sign. No urgency in diving on the loose ball.
Fairly plays it. The centre of the ground, they're looking to reach the halfway. Sirenin works it up. put down by Pay in combination with Sargent. The last has gone as Fittler gets his kick in. Barnhill took him out, but it wasn't late. And now Brett Mullins gets away from a tackle. He beat Chris Johns. He goes back in. He runs into Fittler. Ball and all tackle by Brad Fittler. The blind side is stacked. Four players on the blind. And Dean Pay is tackled 30 metres out.
Brett Mullins has got half a blue jersey on him already.
Away now for Barnhill. No gain in ground. His country go back towards the centre of the ground. Probably to come back with Clyde and Mullins are positioned back on this blind side. Daly is coming from right to left to link up with them now. McGregor follows him across. They've got plenty of personnel on the left. A face ball away. Ryan goes to the 10. Gets it away from Nagus. Nagus gets the play. And country really ripping into the city. 18 points to 2.
Well, it was incredible to think that the try could have been scored because the whole country team had come across, which meant that City should have been able to number up. And you'll see here the pass is the important one from Laurie Daly. He's come across, goes to the defence as we freeze play there. Look at all the City defenders over here. The whole country team has come across. The pass will find this man coming straight. We've got a staggered line for City as play continues. The pass catches out the centre. A little bit of a Shemozzle here with Clyde falling over the tackler. Ken Nagus takes the ball. Nobody in front of him. Very poor covering by City.
Well, it's been down this left-hand side for country. They keep attacking. They must obviously think there's a weakness. A great pass from Laurie Daly. Matt Ryan did everything right, stepped inside, and there's Nagus right next to the post. A good try from the countryside.
They had the whole team across there. I just can't believe that City didn't number up. The whole team came across except the winger. You mentioned, Ray, that Daly and McGregor had come across. And that, to me, is the problem with City. There's no urgency there. No one prepared to cover ground to get there to cover danger.
Well, that's what I said to Mario. You guys were on your way downstairs for the halftime summary. And I said to Mario, it just looks to me like the country players are keener and hungrier to get points on the board and win, ultimately. Wishart converts. Three converted tries now, 20 points to 2 in favour of country, 51 gone, Friday night football. 20 points to 2, the City side getting a thumping here from country, and one of the reasons is this man Lazarus. Mario, I see that Paul Saarinen's getting some attention down there.
Yes, Ray, he's got a groin strain, I'm told it's not too bad, Brad McKay replaces him. Greg Florimo, probably the form player of the competition, gets his chance. He's champing at the bit. Brad Fittler comes off. I'm sure Florimo will do a good job. His combination with Taylor, I think, will play a big part in maybe City coming back, but they look at long odds for that.
You're getting some raps in for North players. Everybody's form player of the competition.
Pete, I wonder how much influence the media has had on this game. When Ricky Stewart was named out of the countryside, I think the City blokes have just relaxed and thought, oh, we'll end the ball game. I know that Phil Gould studied all week to cut out the Ricky Stewart kicking game, and when he's not there, they look like they've relaxed a bit.
I guess that's a reasonable comment, Blocker, but I think John Simon would probably have something to say about that. And he has played a very big role in the match so far. Now, City have got a player down injured. They've only got 12 there on 13 at the moment. Daly is tackled. I'm looking across to identify. It's Jim Dimmock who's out of the line. Simon across the back. Clyde links up. He gets a dummy from Sargent. Wishart turns it back. McGregor's there to support. They're 5 metres out. They're 3 metres out. Country, they look like scoring again. McCormick a dummy half. He's got decoys going everywhere. Simon is with the ball. And they're 2 metres out. This is the last. McCormick a dummy half again. They can wrap it right up here. Daly down, gets up. Clyde turns it back. McCormick looks for the hole. And great defence there by Mark Carroll, puts him away.
Oh, try saver from Carroll. Great lead-up work again from country, but a bone jarrer as Brad McKay makes a good charge 10 metres out. Have a look at this. Playing, keeping the ball alive. It's the last tackle. Clyde did marvellously well. Crash.
Robbie McCormack looked like he thought, geez, I'm in here. Have a look at this. Bang. Mark Carroll come from nowhere. What a smasher.
Jim Dimmock is being assisted from the park. He's got an eye problem there. And this is what happened, apparently, to Jim. He's got, a finger in the eye from Big Sergeant as he went galloping like a wild rhinoceros down the park.
I wonder how Peter Moore and the Canterbury people are feeling now, losing Terry Lamb with a broken arm. This was the guy who was going to come in and fix up that hole. Hopefully for, well, not just Canterbury fans, but for all rugby league fans, Jim Dimmick won't be too injured and take his place as soon as possible.
City straining their way to get it down the ground. They're back just outside their own 20-metre line. Fairley did well. Elias supported. Taylor pushes it out. Hill looks for the gap. Gets to the 30, throws the pass. Scooped off the ground then.
And it's the young players that have come to the fore today. The new players, as in Fairley, he's having a strong game. Dean Pay playing all over the top of the more experienced partners.
Play by Johns. Taken ahead by David Fairley. Taylor. Barnhill it was, trying to put the pressure on him. 20 points to 2 in favour of Country. Oh. Mullins got a high shot. And it's Ian Roberts.
Yeah, good to see Mullins got straight up off the ground. Didn't lie there. Roberts didn't miss him. I don't know whether Mullins might have ducked into it a little bit. He was being wrapped up a little bit lower down by another defender. Coming back, the head fairly high. But Roberts has launched himself. I know that he was trying to go for the chest, but he has got him too high.
Well, this big crowd at Marathon, loving every moment of this. Plenty of their own players in the countryside. Of course, Newcastle, along with Wollongong, probably regarded as the core or the heart of country football for all those years when they went to the cricket ground without access to many of their players swallowed up by Sydney clubs. Now they can call on them, and they look like getting their second win in the eighth playing of Origin football. McCormack, a dummy half, they're on the 20-metre line again. It's territory that they're familiar with. McGregor is running strongly. He looks like he might have his confidence back after that shocking injury at Alice Springs. This is the last. They'll go to the air, will they not? Daly calls for it. And there goes the bomb. It's high, plenty of time, and pressure for Tim Brasher. But did he do it well, the Tiger?
Well, it was a beautiful kick, and Brasher, who's had a little bit of trouble with the hands tonight, came up with a great catch. Roberts takes the 20-metre tap, doesn't take his eye off the ball, Brasher. And that's a superb take.
Fairly. Sunday, of course, we're covering St George and Canterbury from the SFS, the Big Mother's Day promotion down there by St George. And you'll see the highlights on Sunday night. And I'll be down there for the footy show from 12 noon, talking with St George second rower Scott Goulet.
Yes, and Jason Taylor looking to open up in this game. The country forward's getting a bit tired now. Here he goes at the hole, tries to get the impossible ball away. But good play from Taylor. They look like he's going to try and open these country blokes up. They are behind a lot on the scoreboard.
Talking of Taylor, it would seem that he's about to come off, because Craig Field, the youngster we've all been waiting for to see him in the higher level, he's about to come on.
And I'm sure when Craig Field does come on the field, he'll take that line on. He's an expert at running at the big forwards, using his feet. I'm sure you won't see him passing the ball all night.
Country now looking to totally shut the city side out. You'd think they probably already have, but when you're up against a team with the superstars in the city lineup, you can't rest. And Daly is not resting. I know that earlier, Peter, you were sort of talking about his timing might have been off, the weighting of his kicks and things like that. And of course, that could come from the fact that he's been out for quite some time. But I don't think anybody has contributed as heavily as Laurie Daly.
It also comes down to the expectations of him, Ray. Look at this. It's just found touch. Daly kicking there for Wishart. He was on the fly. If it had stayed in the field of play, it was going to be try time. Beautiful work down the blind side. Look, I wasn't being overcritical, because I think that The one thing the country had to have was enormous involvement from their captain. But he just did a couple of things, and his reaction was one that you would expect. The kicks weren't that good early on, but he turned a couple of them into good kicks just with the enthusiasm.
And Pete, we both know that the halfback and the hookers touch the ball mostly in this game. I wouldn't be surprised if Laurie Daly was right up there in the amount of times that he has actually inspired himself right into this game.
Graham Mackay, 35 metres out from his own line. 17 is Mark Carroll. And I was reminded as Mackay went away on that run that he and Ettinghausen, they haven't had the involvement. It probably hasn't been a game for them, but they haven't had the frequency of involvement that Wishart and Nagus have had. Talking of Daly and just getting back onto that comment, of course, he set such high standards for himself. The halfway line is on camera. Florimo slipping, still able to get a pass out the back. Tim Brasher comes in to help, puts a kick on. Mullins is there. He's almost been like a wicket keeper tonight, Mullins, directly in line with anything coming down the ground.
He's had a great game, Brett Mullins. Oh, mistake here by Nagus. There's a chance out wide.
Field picked it up and gave it away. Mackay got it on. Terry Hill puts his ears back, throws the pass, kicked ahead by Craig Field. He's after it. So too is Country. Craig Field dives for it, and Country comes away through Wishart. Well, a couple of players back there looked to go to sleep on the play. I thought for a moment Harrigan's whistle had sounded.
Yeah, it wasn't a very good chase from the countryside, as we've seen. It might be what the city side needs right now as a player like Craig Field. We saw him chase the ball at a million miles an hour. Great vision from him here. A long ball to Mackay. A speculator pass inside from Terry Hill. A kick through. And he chases. Watch this little fella. Here, I want it. I want to score. Great chase from him.
Big Mark Sargent was lumbering around in there, but he basically put himself out of the play and left it to Rod Wishart. And Craig Field, like a thief in the night, really got under his guard. So Country now working it off their 30-metre line. Let's take a comment on the sidelines with Mario Fenech.
Ray, obviously Country have got a great stranglehold on this game. It's to the credit of the Canberra connection, Clyde and Daly, and their former Canberra teammate, Glenn Lazarus. They've certainly controlled the rucks, and they've made a lot more less errors than City today. On the side, Dimmick's okay. He's got a finger in the eye, and he'll be okay.
Well, that's good news on Jim Dimmick. There was a blatant forward pass, I thought, let go by Bill Harrigan, but I'm not blaming him. He had two touch men wide for sound, and they could have given him a call.
And I'm sure Mario would be very happy. Jason Taylor's left the field. They've got that big game tomorrow against the Cronulla Sutherland Sharks.
Ben Elias to dummy half. Roberts takes it up. Carroll goes with him. He drops the ball out the back. Obviously now the time has come for City to take those chances.
Well, was Ian Roberts trying to get a penalty here? He's striking at the ball. Now we watch Roberts when he does strike at the ball here. He's in an offside position for mine, Peter Sterling. He stands to the left or right of the ruck, puts his foot in. You must be directly in front of the player.
Well, I think he was that disappointed with this very ordinary offload here that he was going to do anything humanly possible to get possession back. And he's come up with, well, he's well and truly offside there.
You see what I mean by he stands on the side of the player. Ian Roberts has been doing that for a lot of years.
Yeah, he was just keen to get the ball back, but now Country inside the final 20 minutes here. David Barnhill has been a little bit quiet, but he's worked hard. Another chance to extend this lead.
McCormick a dummy half. They're very deep, Country. They've got plenty of personnel as far back as 20 metres. Look at them. Way back there, they're all wanting a part of it. Put down, though, unfortunately, by the Country number 14, Jason Croker. He has gone on, so has Mark Glanville. So they've all had a taste of it now. Croker, unfortunately for him, putting it down. Salvatore off, Jim Dimmick goes back on. Dimmick packing in to the back of the scrum with Florimo at 5/8 now. And a knock on by Craig Field at the scrum base. So Country, Lady Luck is smiling on them tonight.
And Peter, how many times do we see the ball in the scrum? The halfback wants to go in there and get it out. He should wait for the second rowers to heel the ball out of the scrum. And we see a lot of knock-ons like that in this game.
Country coming away with the scrum win this time. That is Croker, piled into the ground strongly by both Brasher and Florimo. Simon unloads. McGregor handles and then tries to make the break. Daly walking around behind the play, just calling the shots, having a look around, setting his sights on where he's going. Here he goes now, goes himself, holds the ball back and then puts it out the back over the sideline.
You were just badly read there by Paul McGregor. Laurie Daly had the right idea. He went right to the line. The space was on the outside. Here we have it. If McGregor would have stayed back and run into the hole there, it would have been a try to the countryside, I'm sure. If it just would have been back just that little way.
Brad Mackay now. About 15 minutes of the match remaining. And a big gap between the sides. 20 points to 2. Carroll. Harrigan back on in the 10 jumper. Barnhill has worked and worked strongly all night. He probably hasn't had the spotlight on him like Dean Pay, but he certainly has been a worker for them tonight, David Barnhill. His dad, of course, is the boss of Country Rugby League. 14 hit-ups, 21 tackles.
The important thing with David Barnhill, Ray, is he's come up with no mistakes, no errors, no missed tackles. He's done a lot of work, but he's been very safe in everything he's done.
Terry Hill was put under pressure by a little mistake made by Craig Field. Brett Mullins gets the ball in good field position, and he takes the first tackle 39 metres away from the city line. Here they come again. Nagus from Canberra goes away inside the 20-metre line to be pulled down by Ian Roberts. Good defence by the Manly prop forward. It's Simon now. McCormack, Daly, always there. And then the number 10 is Harrigan, 15 metres out from the line. As the countryside looked for another try, the 17 is Mark Glanville, the Nova Castrian, playing in front of his home crowd now. And away for Simon, a long ball required. It's with Croker. Handed down for Clyde, held up, and then behind the runners. Nagus goes back to clean it up and play on, says Harrigan. Five tackles gone. Elias has come up out of the line. He could have been nabbed for offside. A kick in the air, a chance again for the Maroons. It's been put down by the Blues, but Harrigan ordering a line dropout. The breach made by the city side.
Very good kick and a very good chase. Getting a lot of pressure on. See Florimo trying to get under the swirling ball. Got himself in good position, and eventually Mackay, he cannot be offside in the in-goal area, picked the ball up, forcing the line drop out to be taken by Field.
Yeah, go down to the sidelines, a comment from Mario.
Ray, they just haven't had the ball, City, have they? They've got no hope of winning this game because they haven't had the ball. And when they have had the ball, they've spilt it and put themselves under pressure.
Yeah, of course, there's been some very strong defence offered by Country, and that has created a lot of mistakes, hasn't it?
Well, mate, I can only remember one occasion where City had the ball on Country's line. And certainly Country's had the ball a number of times on City's line.
Yeah, I do go back to that 10-metre mark in this second half where City had about three full tackle sets of six in a row down there. Daly nearly giving himself up for the Shepherd. They weren't able to score, and it wasn't that long before Country came down the other end and ran in points.
And they showed the opportunity or their lack of
enthusiasm. Simon did well. McGregor supported. Wishart kicks, and was he taken out late? The referee's gone down as well. Action all over the park.
Looked fairly late, didn't it? Richard,
this is a four over a thong, if you're listening, Fatso.
Well, let's have a look. It's great work from John Simon. Beautiful pass from McGregor. Now, Wishart kicks. Well, it's accidental, fair enough. He took his legs out. If it wasn't accidental, he made it look accidental. And that was good.
It was good play. If it wasn't, I was just about to say that City had an opportunity when Craig Field came on. We saw their true colours when he kicked through, and he was the only chaser. They haven't got as much enthusiasm as the Country team tonight.
Now Benny Elias starts to run. A forlorn hope, of course, but Craig Field delivers for Dimmock, and Dimmock has put away. Harrigan around the legs. Fairley has gone off for City. Mackay goes up to the 30-metre line. 20 points to 2 the score. A long ball from Craig Field for Greg Florimo. Florimo stands, he's so strong, and Brasher is put away. Five tackles gone, and the kick is on. Craig Field putting it high, back across to the left. down over there, but I do think probably handled last by City, so it's the turnover. And on the 10-metre line, Country rucking it out now. 20,000 almost, in fact 19,386 here at Newcastle's stadium tonight, 19,386. Glanville. Barnhill wide. Cuts out Daly for Nagus. Ettinghausen wraps him up just outside the 30-metre line. He's done little wrong, Ken Nagus, in his debut match. Florimo's knock on. And we'll take a break and be back with more. With 69 minutes gone, 20-2, Country over City. Rejoin us from our network of stations around Australia, the Nine Network. Rugby League on a Friday, the representative version. And this is Bradley Clyde, who scored the first try for Country. Croker off of the dummy run, the decoy run. Harrigan takes the tackle.
And have a look at the Country players. They're all pushing each other out of the road. That shows their enthusiasm. A great run from Harrigan then.
They've given themselves width and depth. And that's what they've provided in attack all night. Everybody's got their hand up. They either want to make the tackle or they want to run with the football. And McGregor, it's good to see him playing confidently tonight. Mullins plays it. Simon away from dummy half, puts the kick in for himself. He'll regather, will he? Gets another kick and off the knee. Cleaned up by Ettinghausen. Gets under a high tackle from Clyde. To be cleaned up in turn by Croker. Now Graham Mackay out to the 20-metre line. Not held. Escapes that tackle. Gets it out to the 30-metre point. Elias. Carroll. Pushing it on towards the 40-metre line now. Salvatore comes in closer to the ruck. He gets a ball across the face and works it up towards the halfway mark. Field. Florimo. Second man play. A dummy by Johns. Ettinghausen was waiting for it. Field goes to dummy half. Ben Elias goes to the blind to give him a decoy, but Field puts the kick in and finds the line. About 15 metres out from Country's line.
We've got under 10 minutes to go in this match now, and I just wonder how the selectors are feeling, just how important this game is going to be in the makeup of the state side. Brad Fittler would be under some pressure. Daly's been outstanding, but so too has Paul McGregor in the centres. I wonder about the hooker battle. Has Robbie McCormack done enough out there against Ben Elias? Maybe grab that jersey, and really on this performance here, the Country pack has to dominate for that first state game at the football stadium. Mario Fenwick on the sideline.
Sterlo, hasn't Mullins had a game? Speaking of state of origin selection, has he done enough to hold the fullback position? I think he's had a great game, and certainly he's going to put the pressure on the representative selectors.
Well, again, the important thing, Mario, is that, OK, if this is a possibles, probables, as we say, so too is every game in Winfield Cup on the weekends. And Mullins, from what I've seen the last couple of weeks, has done enough in the weekend football, backed it up with a great performance tonight. He has outplayed Tim Brasher. I've got no doubts about that. He should be in the spot if that's the criteria. If form is a criteria, he's there.
And he's had a great game today, and certainly this is a great test of his ability, and his form with Canberra has been sensational. But, mate, you never know what these selectors, you know what they're like.
Yeah, Peter, are we talking about form on just tonight, or are we talking about form for the full season?
Well, that's what I'm saying. Like, I think his form has been good
enough. His form tonight has been better than Timmy Brash's, but Timmy Brasher, I saw him play last week, he was in sensational form.
Harrigan's been ordered to the blood bin. He's been conducting a running battle between himself, Bill Harrigan, and the Red Cross all night. Yeah, keep in mind that Timmy Brasher, of course, is playing behind a beaten Balmain side for the major part too, whereas Brett is playing in that very good Canberra unit. But Peter's right, on tonight, you'd have to pick Mullins.
I'd have to agree with that, but I'm saying, is it the full season that we pick the state of origin, and he is the incumbent New South Wales fullback,
well,
Timmy Brash.
We'll see. Actually, the Canberra connection has been very important for country out there tonight, with Clyde out wide, working off Daly and Nagus there with Mullins. Oh, good ball here, chance. Florimo finds Fittler. No, that's Johns.
30 metres out from the line.
I was going good too, Raz, wasn't I? Fatty would have known I was going good.
Field through to Florimo, and then Dimmick holds it back, but the ball goes to ground. Brad Mackay was really put under some pressure with the pass. Then again, the City side can do nothing more than push the pass now, hoping for a crack to appear. But they've scarcely broken the country line when you think about it.
Well, I don't think they've had that much ball, as Mario Fenwick alluded to earlier in the call. It's just been the ball that City have had. They seem to lose it early in the tackle count.
That's a fair thing to say, Blocker, but then again, they have made the mistakes that has offered the possession in the majority to country too.
Yes, you're right there, Ray. As I said, it has been the
mistakes. Here's McGregor, Blocker, striding out, but Clyde puts it down. Advantage for City, Brasher to play it. Carroll. Mackay. He really knows that it hasn't been a good game for the wingers in the City side. And Mackay, you will notice in the second half, he's gone looking for it. Salvatore makes a good run. 23 metres out from the country line. They come across to a deep back line. Field to Dimmick and Field again. Then the pass. It goes over the shoulder of Ettinghausen. A race between Ettinghausen and Nagus. And eventually, Nagus wins the race. The rolling football, it can do some evil things to you. Glanville crossing the halfway mark. Bumps away from another. Not a great deal of support for Mark Glanville. 42 metres out from the line. We're inside the last 5 minutes. Simon sends the Newcastle player, Sargent, 38 metres out from the line. McCormick comes back to the blind side. Barnhill goes charging at them. Penalty goes to country. Infringement in the play, the ball against the City side.
Yeah, Barnhill, in his desperation to get a quick play, the ball there, was impeded by Jim Dimmick. Pushed him down that extra time. And one of those line ball decisions. I don't know whether Barnhill made much of an effort to get to his feet. Harrigan has ruled in country's favour. Rod Wishart. Well, I think the crowd will be a little bit disappointed. I think they'd have liked country to have gone for touch.
Just don't forget that man, David Barnhill, will be featuring in our Sunday match replay. Saints and Canterbury. 6:30, you'll see the highlights of that. St. George, of course, having to come back from a whacking at the hands of Illawarra. And up in front of that, of course, the footy show at 12 noon. Fatty will be back on Sunday, crutches and all.
I haven't really missed him that much. Fatty who?
Fatty who? I tell you what, Block has just stood up for a second. My goodness, there's a bit more room here now. Here's Wishart. That looks okay, and straight between the posts. Wishart has had an immaculate night off the boot. 22-2, just 3 minutes remaining. Crowd, many of them heading for the exits, but the greater bulk of them still here. 20,000 to see the country cousins do it for the second time in the eight-year history of Origin football. And, of course, the previous win to the 1992 victory under Mick Cronin and Laurie Daly was back in 1975, and handshakes all round for one of rugby league's superstars, Laurie Daly.
Chris Anderson has again shown his skill as a coach. One thing in representative football that you don't want to do is take anything away from the players. They're there because they're the best players in the competition. Let them play the natural game. That's a knock on there from Lazarus. I'm sure they've had a couple of pet plays, but really he's just allowed them to play what's in front and let their skill take over.
Well, let's go down to the sideline. A comment from Mario.
Ray, country have certainly dominated this game.
Will they dominate the State of Origin selection? That's the question. The man, the average man in the street feels that this game is just a nothing game, really. So let's just see what happens. I believe Mullins has done enough in this game to cement a fullback spot. I agree with Block's situation where, obviously, Brash has been there and done that and been a great player for New South Wales, but the game should be picked, players should be picked on form.
Yeah, well, I don't want to put you on the spot, Mario. I guess you guys will talk about it on Sunday, but out of this match, there's probably more than just Brett Mullins that you guys are alluding to. Blokes like Dean Pay and those fellows, David Barnhill, they must also be in the forefront of your minds.
Well, obviously, Dean Pay is a wild card, as we spoke before the game, and he's done himself proud. But look, I believe Mullins is a standout for the fullback position. His return of play has been unbelievable. He's been instrumental in this victory today, and I believe he deserves his chance.
Florimo trying everything he knows to keep the ball alive and promote the hopes of City, but they are long gone.
Well, if Brett Mullins wasn't in the side, we've got him in by now. As 30 seconds to go, John Simon takes the ball over halfway.
I just don't know whether he's on a sling or not. He's on a sling or what?
Great charge from Sargent once again. Hasn't he found some form in the last couple of weeks? Under 20 to go. A big night for the country boys.
Of course, tonight we're looking for the Ansett man of the match, one of the world's great airlines. And our other great man of the match sponsor, MMI, firmly implanted on the jumpers of the country team. That doesn't worry Ansett. They service the country as well. And this match is over. Country have won for the third time in 20 matches. If you go back to include 1975, and this has been a superb performance. When we came on at the top of the show with the news that Rick Stewart was out, I referred to the betting, and City were a long odds on to win, but they've been humble. 22 points to 2. Country winning by 22-2. Clyde, Pay and Nagus got the tries. Wishart impeccable with the boot, 5 out of 5, and really he was the best winger on the ground. And for City, just those 2 points kicked by Jason Taylor. But it came down, I guess, to what appeared a more enthusiastic and hungrier side in the maroon jumpers of the country, jumpers that they wear with a tremendous amount of pride. They always have, even when given a shellacking in the old days back at the Sydney Cricket Ground. Dynamic Daly says the sign. He was all of that tonight. We'll take a break and Peter will come back and he'll wrap it up with Blocker. We'll be back with you, of course, again for my part on Sunday. In the meantime, here's a break. Back with Sterlo in a moment.
On stadium, a dominant performance has seen Country of Origin defeat City of Origin 22-2. 3 tries to 0, probably a fair indication of the game. Clyde, Pay and Nagus all getting tries. Wishart a great night with the boot, and Jason Taylor kicked his 1 from 1. Really a performance set up by the forwards. They scored points late in the first half and that gave them the platform to go on in the second 40 minutes. A couple of standout performers. A very difficult decision once again, but the man we chose as our man of the match is now with Steve Roach.
$1,000 Ansett Airlines man of the match, Bradley Clyde. Congratulations. Great start to the representative season for yourself.
Thanks very much, Roachie. I missed out last year, so I was looking for, at least a good start.
Yeah, that City side didn't seem to have that much ball in the second half, but you guys in defence were scrambling well all game.
Yeah, all week we decided that we'd show a lot of spirit, and I think the guys just won today through just pure enthusiasm.
Yeah, Brad, you kept stacking the blind side. That's where you got most of your tries. Was that a ploy from Chris Anderson?
No, Chris just asked me to exploit it if ever they were short, and I tried my best, but to City's credit, they played very well and they defended very well.
A couple of newcomers, Dean Pay, outstanding game from him. A try, set one up too.
Yeah, when we play against Canterbury, Dean Pay's always their best performer, and again tonight he showed his worth.
Thanks very much, mate. Enjoy the 1,000, I'm sure you will.
Thanks very much, I need it.
I'm sure that anybody who follows rugby league recognises this man on screen, Brad Clyde, as the best forward in the world. He confirmed that rating again tonight with a powerhouse performance. I mentioned the fact that the Canberra connection was so important tonight, and his main ally, I thought, in bringing about the defeat of City was the captain, Laurie Daly. Had a super game for them, and he now joins Steve Roach.
Laurie, sweet revenge from last year. Countryside pretty ordinary last year. Great tonight.
Yeah, we certainly were ordinary last year, and that was something we talked about. And we control the ball a lot better. And we thought we'd try and play a bit of football this year, and we've come up trumps.
Laurie, your involvement in the game, you handle the ball probably more than any other player in the field. A lot of short shots on the blind side. Was that a ploy?
Yeah, it was. You know, Chris thought we might be able to get them down the short sides a few times, and as it happened, worked off, and yeah, it was great.
I thought the City side relaxed a bit after they heard Ricky Stewart wasn't in the side. I thought John Simon was outstanding tonight.
Oh, he certainly was. Every time Johnny fills in for Ricky, he plays outstanding football, and you're probably right there. As soon as I heard that Ricky was out, they probably dropped off a gear, but full credit to all our guys because they played particularly well.
All set to explode for the State of Origin number one?
Hope so, mate. Hopefully, mate, I know you'll get better, but we'll see what happens, mate.
Good on you, mate. Thanks for your time.
Thanks a lot.
A real captain's knock there from Laurie Daly. Already had some injury problems. He mentioned the knee there. I'm sure that all Canberra fans and New South Wales fans are hoping that Laurie Daly can now get through the rest of the season uninjured. A mammoth dividend tonight in footy. Tab, pick the score. Have a look at this one. $3,422.20 for that 22-2 scoreline. And, of course, the rugby league continues on Sunday, Mother's Day. We go to the Sydney Football Stadium. A great clash. The St George Dragons smarting after a 24-0 loss last week up against the Canterbury Bankstown Bulldogs. They, of course, without Terry Lamb, but still a very impressive side this year, Canterbury. Been a great night here. Our first representative game of the year. A lot more coming up. Of course, we've got the footy show on Sunday, but our next venue will be the Sydney Football Stadium. We look forward to your company on Sunday afternoon. For now, on behalf of the entire wide world of the sports football team from the Marathon Stadium, we say good night.
McCormack works the blind side. Dean Pay runs onto it strongly. Bradley Clyde, a try, yes. Richard from the sideline. Look at this one. No, it's a beauty. Now McGregor follows him across. They've got plenty of personnel on the left. A late ball away. Ryan goes to the 10. Gets it away from Nagus. Nagus gets the try. And Country really ripping into the city.
And this match is over. Country have won for the third time in 20 matches.
I'm a police officer, lady.
We bring that dog in here. Have a dog. Everyone here brings their connection, and we'll talk to you.
Excuse your problem. I don't have a problem. My ass. That's exactly what he did. He went between me and Lyman. He took the bullet.
Been after Lyman for 2 years. It wasn't worth it. Just wasn't worth it, you know that? You know, you could have gotten killed.
You did.
Yeah, right. Shoot. Susan Peters. I can't take this anymore. Susan Peters,
3422. Tonight on League Roundup, we take a look back on the week that was. Highlights of the City Country Clash. The Raiders going down to the Gold Coast, and we'll talk with Brett Mullins.
Match is over. Country have won for the third time in 20 matches. If you go back,
I was right to play on Friday night. Although some people didn't think I was, but I was certainly right. And you know, as I say, I just heard it again, and I'll have to see how it comes.
Well, City Country time. It's all over and done with. Laurie Daly thought he was right. Sean McRae, did you think Laurie Daly was right taking part in the game?
Yes, I agree with what Laurie just said, Phil. I think that you can take a lot of advice from medical staff, doctors, physiotherapists, trainers, even your coaches. But it's really up to the player, I think, is the bottom line. And he was very, very confident. All the tests that had been performed on his knee was that that the knee joint itself was very stable. And, you know, he felt like he was able to get through a game. So he went for it. And I still totally support his decision.
Ricky Stewart's back with us. Rick, a bit of a nothing match to get injured in like that.
Yeah, one of the main reasons I pulled out, Phil, was, you know, I could have probably played the game at 90%. But I knew that if I got through that game, I was going to be putting myself back a week or two and then missing out on Raiders and maybe State of Origin. So, you know, and I agree with Sean, as Sean said, that sometimes the medical staff can give you an opinion and they think that you can get onto the field, or you may not be able to get onto the field, but deep down you know how your injury is. And, I mean, you're the only one who can really tell if you're 100% or not. And as Sean said, I agree with him that Laurie was right to play.
OK, well, welcome once again to League Roundup. Sean, as far as that City-Country match was concerned, what did you think of the game as a whole?
Well, I thought it started off with a reasonable level of intensity, to be quite honest with you, and that surprised me because I thought it would probably be open football right from the start.